I'm out here again with my W123, and if you recall, a while back I did an alternator upgrade. So we moved from the smaller 55 or 65 amp stock alternator to a 115 amp AL129X, and I did that a number of years ago before that video ever made it onto my channel, and it has been performing fantastically for years. But just recently, I had an issue where I was on a longer trip and my voltage dipped down below 12 volts because I had the AC on, the headlights on, playing the radio, and my voltage dipped down. So I was able to tell that the voltage was dropping and turned off my accessories, and my voltage hovered at around 11.9 or 12 volts, which is discharging the battery. It should be 12.5, would be fully charged, and ideally around 14 would be fully charging at highway speeds. And my car was not charging, which led to an issue. When I got to my destination, the battery was partially depleted, and it was difficult to start. But typically speaking, alternators don't often fail in a mechanical fashion or even in an electronic fashion. There's not a lot to an alternator, and there's not a lot that wears, except the voltage regulator has two brushes that it uses for excitation to spark a magnetic field to enable the alternator to generate current. And those brushes can wear down. When they do, you get diminished or erratic voltage output, and basically exactly the issues I've got. So the nice thing about a voltage regulator on most alternators is it is replaceable. So let me show you on my old stock alternator what the voltage regulator looks like. We'll take it off and you can see the brushes. You can see that this is something that is meant to be taken off and serviced. So I'm gonna crawl under my car now. It's going to be difficult for me to film. That's why I showed you what we're doing on that old alternator, the factory one. That's what we're going to be doing under my car to change out my hopefully failing alternator with this brand new regulator. So let's get this put in and see if it restores my charging system performance.
Could be we've got a diode or something going bad in the alternator internally. Just not as common as the regulator, but very good possibility.
Well, it's disappointing that it doesn't seem like the voltage regulator solved my charging issue. We might have something a little bit deeper. Maybe one of the windings in the alternator is going bad, or one of the diodes or things in there that rectifies the current. Something's going on, and it might be time to replace that alternator with a fresh one. We've got the fresh, brand new alternator installed. Let's see if that solved our charging issue.
That's certainly higher than it was, and it's not fluctuating like it was before. Let's try giving it a little throttle. Yeah, 14. That's like 1200 RPM. We're up to 14 volts.
Well, there we have it. It was more than just the voltage regulator on my car, but that might not be the case on your car. A lot of times, if those windings or the diodes and stuff inside your alternator haven't failed, that voltage regulator is quite likely to be the root cause of it. It just wasn't in my case. But hopefully this was interesting, helpful for you to know that that is something that is changeable should you want to give that a try before you go through the process of removing your alternator and replacing it with a new one. Thanks for watching.